Good morning all. Now we will discuss about the interrupt of 8086. What is interrupt? It interrupts the execution of a normal program. It disturbs the execution of a normal program. When interrupt occurs, the processor stops the normal execution of the instruction and it goes to the ISR. ISR is interrupt service routine. After execution of interrupt, it returns back to the normal execution of the program. The processor can be interrupted in following ways. Here we can generate the interrupt by using a peripheral device which are connected with the 8086 controller. We can generate the interrupt by using a program. Within the program, we have a special instruction which is called as the software. We can generate the interrupt by using the exceptional condition, which means at zero condition we can generate the interrupt. Next one is the classification of interrupts. We have two types of interrupt, hardware interrupt and software interrupt. In hardware interrupt, we have maskable interrupt and non-maskable interrupt. We have the two condition. First one is definitely accept the interrupt signal. Second one is the it rejects the interrupt signal. Here, non-maskable interrupt accept the interrupt signal. Maskable interrupt rejects the interrupt signal until execution of the normal main program of the processor. Next one is the software interrupt. Here the software interrupt has 256 types of software interrupt. Next one is the hardware interrupt. Here we can generate the interrupt by using the external hardware device. Here we can send the interrupt signal to the particular two pins of the processor is called as a hardware interrupt. Here the two pins are INTR and NMI. NMI is the non-maskable interrupt, INTR is the maskable interrupt. The maskable interrupt is INTR and non-maskable interrupt is NMI. These are the some of the hardware devices which are connected with the 8086 processor, which is used to generate the interrupt signal. For example, when we pressing the keyboard, it generates the interrupt signal. Next one is the maskable interrupt and non-maskable interrupt. Here the processor has the two conditions for accepting or rejecting the hardware interrupt. Here the processor rejects the hardware interrupt. It is referred as the maskable interrupt. And it accepts the hardware interrupt. It is referred as the non-maskable interrupt. Here we can set the interrupt flag to make a unmask the interrupt or which is called as a non-maskable interrupt. When non-maskable interrupt occurs, it stops the normal execution of the main program. It goes to the ISR interrupt service routine. After completion of non-maskable interrupt, it returns back to the current program. Non-maskable interrupt occurs during the following conditions: used during power failures and used during critical response time, used during non-recoverable hardware errors, used watchdog interrupt, used during memory parity errors. Next one is the software interrupt. Here we can generate the software interrupt by using a special instruction which is called as the software interrupt. Here we have 256 types of software interrupt which is specified as INTN. So N is the number of types which is ranges from 0 to 255.